Let's move on to question two. We need to find if there are any suspected outliers. And it's related to the five-number summary, but how exactly do we do that? There's no clear-cut answer, but we're going to follow the textbook and use what is called the 1.5-time interquartile range criteria to find if something is an outlier. What it really says is if it's too far away from the other value, there's something strange about this value. One way to think about that is to have a box plot in mind. So if that's my box plot at the first quartile, that's the median, and that's the third quartile. The interquartile range is the width of this box. It measures spread. And the way to calculate this, the interquartile range can be obtained by taking the third quartile and subtracting the first one. So you then multiply this quantity by 1.5 and you add that to the third quartile and you get some value. Let's say it's here. Anything which is beyond that value, so anything here, would be considered a suspected outlier. Then you take the exact same thing, so that's my, so this value there, sorry, let me write this. So that's going to be Q3 plus 1.5 times the interquartile range. So this distance there is 1.5 times the interquartile range. You draw it on the other side, so 1.5 times the interquartile range. Here you will get some value again, which will be the first quartile minus 1.5, the interquartile range. And same thing, anything on this side will be considered too far away from the rest of the value, so it deserved being taken a look at, and that's why we call them suspected outliers. We are now ready to find the suspected outliers for the ages of students. So we know that any value above the third quartile plus 1.5 times the interquartile will be a suspected outlier. So the first thing we do is to calculate the thresholds. The interquartile range is the third quartile minus the first one, namely 22.25 minus 19, which is 3.5. So now the lower limit for outliers will be Q1 minus 1.5 times the interquartile range. So we calculate this. It's going to be 19 minus 1.5 times 3.5, and that is 13.75. Anything below 13.75 is a suspected outlier. So where is that? So the thing is, my 13.75 is somewhere here, and there is nothing below. So we can see that there's no lower suspected outlier. We now do the same thing for the upper outliers. So the upper threshold for outliers is the third quartile plus 1.5 times the interquartile range. That is 22.5 plus 1.5 times 3.5, and that is 27.75. So where does that lie? 27.75 would be here. So really that is third quartile plus 1.5 times the interquartile range. And as we said, anything above that would be considered a suspected outlier. So we found one. 29 is a suspected outlier. So 29 is a suspected upper outlier and there's no suspected lower outlier. Maybe we could add upper. For those of you who would like to look at the final version of a typed solution, you can just pause the video. We now want to find the suspected outliers, but this time we want to use the software R. So, because in practice the data won't always be ordered for you, I've been using the same numbers, but I mixed them up a little bit. See, I didn't do much. Basically, this 25 used to be there and this 18 used to be at the beginning. So the first thing you will do is to combine all your numbers into one object and you give it a name. So I called it H. you ask R to calculate the five-number summary of that object, and you will get those numbers. This is the minimum, so the second number on the list is the first quartile. So that's what I did here. So let Q1 be the second number from this five-number summary list. This means assign to Q1 this value. So the third quartile is the fourth element on the list, so I stored the result into Q3. Now, in order to calculate the lower outlier threshold, same calculation as before, I take Q1 minus 1.5 times the interquartile range, and I store the result in a variable called lower outlier threshold, and same thing for the upper one. I've combined them into one single object so I could print them into one single line. So you recognize the 27.75, anything above that is an upper outlier. And you also recognize the 13.75, and any number below that will be a lower outlier. Once you've done that, you can sort your data to put it in increasing order and then finish just the way we did by hand. Anything below 13.75 will be a lower suspected outlier, so there's none. And anything above 27.75 would be a suspected upper outlier. So of course, we get the same conclusion that 29 is a suspected outlier. Here is another way to find the suspected outliers using R. So the beginning is exactly the same. You calculate the two thresholds, but then you add this command. So is H greater than the upper outlier threshold? So what R will do, it will take all the numbers in the list one by one, and for each of them, it will tell you whether the condition is satisfied. So here, it's false for all of them except the last one. So this corresponds to that, which means that H is greater than the 27.75 only for the last one, and the last one is 29. Now you could do the same thing using the lower outlier threshold. And so for each value on the list, you check whether they are less than the lower outlier threshold, and in that case you can see that the condition is never satisfied, so none of this value is a suspected lower outlier. What you could do at this point, really this is enough to find that this is 29, but what you could also do is ask R, so which of this value satisfy the condition. The problem, if you do this, it will give you the rank in the list. So there are 19 values, so it will tell you the 19th value is an outlier. So if you want to know what exactly is the 19th value, you need to add that, just like before, age of 2 gives you the second on the list. And that way you get directly the outlier you wanted.